thanks for joining us today. My name is Shannon from Strategic Intervention Solutions. We're going to be talking about many games that we can play with Deco Dots. If you aren't familiar with our website, it's sis4teachers.org. You can subscribe to our blog and all the information that we have on the website, as well as our Facebook. If you search Strategic Intervention Solutions, you can find us and keep up to date. Today we're going to talk about our new deck of cards that just got released for the second edition of Deco Dots. It has a new fun character named Dotson on it that kids are very excited about that goes along with our Math Mites. He's a Math Mite Junior and goes along with our collection of Math Mite characters. In the Deco Dots, kids are going to be doing lots of activities with subitizing, which is instantly recognizing numbers, quantities without counting. The Deco Dots is set up in a deck where there's actually four decks in one. The decks are different colors to help differentiate instruction either at home or with teachers. We're gonna go ahead and open up a set of Deco Dots to kind of give you an example of what it would look like if you purchased the Deco Dots. They have three distinct colors inside of them, of which indicate their level of complexity. The first color that we come to is the red deck. The red deck is really great for preschoolers. It's great for kindergartners that are early on into subitizing and understanding number quantity. These decks are all indicated with a 5 frame. The 5 frame does not obviously go higher than 5, but there's quantities 0 to 5 in this deck to help kids to instantly recognize how many there is without counting. A lot of kids will say that that is 3. We want them to tell us why they know. They know it's 3 because there's 2 and 1 more, or they might know that it's 3 because there's 2 empty in the 5 frame. Each set of the Deco Dots, as you look at them, have a circle at the bottom in the left-hand corner. The circle here is so that you can label your Deco Dots, so that you know when a Deco Dot falls in your classroom, you know where it is. So in this deck, I've just named this one kind of the sunglass smiley face, the yellow smiley face, and we want the kids to be able to know if that Deco Dot drops, it goes back with that set of Deco Dots. Once students learn how to understand the 5-frame deck, you want them actually to move into the green deck. The green deck is comprised of all scatters. The scatters in the green deck are differentiated in a certain way. So if I'll pull this deck up and have you like look closely at Dotson. If we look at Dotson's sneakers here, there's no stars on his sneakers, but when we look over here, there are stars. This is an indicator for teachers, not for students, for them to understand that there are different levels within the cards as we're using them. So if I were to flip over a card in the part without stars, the quantities are actually lower. They're 0 to 5. But if I flipped over the one where he does have the stars on his shoes, these are going to be higher quantities, 6 through 10. So the idea here is that the kids, you can actually differentiate this. So if we think of the idea of subitizing and understanding how kids get to conservation to a number, we would want to start off with having them understand it to 5. So the first level would be this 5 frame because it's an arranged line. We would want then for students to move into the Deco Dots that are green with Dotson without having the stars on his shoes, because these are scattered arrangements, making sure that kids just didn't memorize the 5 frame. They're going into the green deck and seeing it in the scatter. Once students have understood conservation to 5, are able to subitize with reasoning, you can move them into the yellow deck. At any point in time during Deco Dots, if you see students pointing and counting, you've misleveled the deck. We want them to be really appropriated the right way so that they are able to independently work on the games that they're playing. The yellow deck is all full of 10 frames, so if you can kind of think of these all in an arranged line. So when we look at these different amounts, it's similar to the 5-frame, we're just advancing it up to the 10-frame. There's 4 of every card in here, so there's 4 5s, there's 4 6s, and kind of features the organized 10-frame way. Once a child's able to play the games with Deco Dots with this level, we want them then to move into the other part of the green level, which that would obviously be still continuing with conservation to 10 to get them to understand how many there are without counting. So that would indicate that you'd want to go to the ones that's in the green deck with the stars on it. So again, if you look at these, all these quantities are 6 through 10, which makes it more complex. So the order of the Deco Dots really goes the red deck, then you're going to go to your green deck without the stars on Dotson's sneakers, and then you're going to go into the yellow deck, and then you're gonna go into the green deck. And the reasoning for this is we want to have a good instructional match for kids while they're playing the game, so they end up developing numeracy and are also able to have communicated thinking while they're playing the different games. The deco dots, each deck features, so if you look at the red deck and if you look at the yellow deck, like I said, it features four of every value. The green deck has an indicator sheet to tell you how many cards are in each of the green decks so that you'd be able to look to see how many are in the deck itself. Each card also features two wild cards. I actually kind of like the wild cards for Dotson. He's sticking his tongue out and being silly, so the kids really like this. But the idea here is that the wild card will play a role while we're playing the different deco dot games for kids to decide what value they want that card to be. If they're using the wild in the red deck, that's going to be up to five. That's the highest that they can go up to. If they pull up a wild, they can make it a five or any other number lower than that. If they're playing in the yellow or the green deck, they can make the wild any number up to its highest value, so it could be up to 10. Now with deco dots, a lot of the games you'll do a single flip for younger students, but we also can use these games even into second and third grade. So some things that you can do with deco dots to make things more challenging is to give kids a double flip, where you actually would flip two cards and have them use the total instead of just looking at one card. Now again, if you wanted to make it more complex, I would probably pick the green deck where you have the stars on Dotson, because the total for these can go up to 10. So within the green deck where you have the stars on Dotson, to make it more challenging for students, you can have them do a double flip and add up quantities all the way up to 20. If you're working with second and third graders who are really doing really well at partial sums and are understanding how to add their tens and ones together, you can take the green deck and actually make it the reds worth 10. So if I put these two here on this card, if I was looking at them as they were younger, it might be 9, and this one here would be 8, and we would be adding the totals together. But in this case, we're gonna go ahead and make the reds worth 10. So when you're looking at this card here that I'm pointing to, this would be 45, and this card here would be 44. So the idea is the kids would add maybe their tens and ones together to know that they have 40 here and 40 here, so I know that the total is 80. And then when I'm looking here, I know that my ones equal 9, so that this is actually total to 89. Deco Dots allows for you to be able to give kids more rigor within what you're doing in your instruction just by how you're tailoring the different colors that are in the Deco Dots. When we're looking at storage for deco dots in the classroom, it can become quite complicated. So that's one of the reasons why we have the stickering in the left-hand corner, or you could label the deck A deck or the blue deck or however you'd like to label it. The easier part to do when you're using deco dots is to have actual containers that you might put inside of your math salad bar. The math salad bar is a central location in a lot of our project schools where we keep our math manipulatives. And so we could have all of the green deck cards placed in here. They're already all stickered. You could, if you wanted to, separate these decks, especially if you're a kindergarten teacher. You could take out the ones with the stars and then take out the ones without the stars on his shoes to kind of indicate where those would go. But you'd kind of have your spot, whether it's a Ziploc bag or you use even a, you could even use a soap container from the dollar store and put them in here. But so you kind of see the yellow deck in here, and then you can kind of organize those in your drawer for the games. When we're looking at deco dots, they're sold in a variety of ways. One of the ways is you can just buy a single deck, and then we have a download companion that goes along with it with our video tutorials that will help really explain to any parent or teacher how to use deco dots. We thank you so much for joining us for our tutorial videos that we're going to be doing on the deco dot games, and we hope that you visit us at sis4teachers.org and follow us on Facebook at Strategic Intervention Solutions.